It's showtime. Facebook, I do not own the rights to this music. I'm Otis Mack, Chicago's Heavy Diva, and this is Cocktails and Conversations, episode number 34. Sponsored by Fahrenheit, Chicago, Equality, Illinois. Come on. Excuse my indulgence. Y'all come around the computer. Grab your favorite beverage. Share the video. Let somebody know that we are live right here from the Diva's Mansion. This is Cocktails and Conversations. Facebook, I do not own the rights to this music. And you know this. I don't want no problems out of y'all. Do I look all right? I see you, Mia. Kevin, I see you, Juanita. Linda Daniels, hey, baby. Hey, Dre, how's my baby? Duke, I see you. Yes, good evening to you as well. Yes. Get into it, baby. Evangelist, I see you, baby. Evangelist Jones. Hey, Juan. Hey, Julian, the caterer. B. Kayla, my sister. I love you, baby. Linda Boykin. Hey, Tony. Forrest B. and Tony Dobbs. Happy Wednesday to you, baby. I'm here to help you tonight. Hey, Duran. That's my son. Hey, Dion and Sheila. Steve Fetting, man. What's going on to you? Marion Gray. How are you? Tarris. Hey, baby. Hey, Stephanie. Y'all share the video. I'm here to help you tonight. Grab your favorite beverage and come around the computer. It's tonight's going to be epic. Yes, y'all come out. Baby, this is a Fahrenheit weekend. Chicago, it is going down starting Friday night. Hey, Stephanie. Myron Gray. Hello, baby. Don't hate on me now. Hit me. I see you. I see you. I see you. What you say? Facebook, I do not own the rights to this music. I'm Otis Mack, Chicago's Heavy Demon. This is the 31st episode of Cocktails and Conversations. Sponsored by Equality of Illinois and Gay Men of Black Caucus. Fahrenheit Chicago coming up here in Chicago this weekend. Anthony Galloway, if you're listening, tune in. I'm going to invite you to talk to my audience tonight. Ooh, I like that. What do you say? Listen. Any old school folk out there, Donna, do I see you, baby? Oh. Hey, Mary. Sandra, what's going on? I'm here to hold you tonight. Hey, Reggie. Grab your beverage and come around the computer. Don't make me tow it. What? Who? Ah, you don't want it. You don't want it. Listen, I'm Otis Mack, Chicago's Heavy Diva, and this is our 34th fourth episode of Cocktails and Conversations. Y'all make some noise in this building. Make some noise. Listen, tonight, our segment is episode 34, and I am sponsored in part by Equality of Illinois, the sponsor of Fahrenheit Chicago, the LGBTQ Big Beach weekend, this weekend here in Chicago. Baby, it's going to be epic starting Friday night with a big skate party at the rink hosted by myself, along with my partner in crime, Eric Dante. We will be at the rink at 1122 East 82nd Street. That's Friday night, midnight skate from 12 midnight to 3 a.m. And I understand there's some special guests, celebrity guests, who's going to be coming through there from Love and Hip Hop. Y'all come on and check us out this Friday night, Fahrenheit kickoff at the rink. And also, don't forget, the rooftop party will be this Saturday at the Promontory from 3 to 9 p.m. I'll be there. Ruffy will be there. Terry will be there. DJ Superman will be there. Honey, it's going to be epic Saturday at the Promontory from 3 to 9. And then the Big Beach Party will convene on Sunday, this Sunday, August the 26th, at Oakwood Beach. Oakwood Beach, that's 41st and Lakeshore Drive, okay? It's the Southside Pride Weekend. It is going to be simply amazing, hosted by Otis Mac Ruff and Stuff and Terry DeMore. And we got divas and DJs from all over the country to do. Teresa Griffin goes on stage at 2 o'clock, along with Tink will come on stage at 4 o'clock. So y'all get there early. We have an early church service, so you ain't got to make it. If you can't make it to your church service Sunday, we're going to bring the Lord to you on the beach. On this Sunday, church service will start at 11 a.m. Okay? Excuse my indulgence. So get your beverages, get your tents, get your beverages, get your tents, get your beverages, get your tents, get a good attitude, get you some sunscreen and an umbrella, bring a table, barbecue. It is going to be going down at Oakwood Beach this Saturday. Pride South, sponsored by Equality of Illinois, Howard Brown, Miller's Beer, the Legal Counsel, Breakthrough Beverage, Miller's and Coors, the AIDS Foundation of Chicago, Allstate, T-Pan, Healthy Chicago, Planned Parenthood, everybody will be out on this Sunday. So make sure you plan to be in attendance. Also, the Sunday is a free event. There is no cover charge. However, we do have a VIP area and a VIP stage and tent. If you want to have free beverages and food, and I think it's only $15, you can come on, get full with me, honey. It's going to be going down, okay? This Sunday at Oakwood Beach from 11 to 7, DJ Superman, DJ Unknown, DJ Darrell, DJ. Baby, they are coming from every nation this Sunday. You want to be in attendance. Early attendance is strongly recommended. Fahrenheit, Chicago. Excuse my indulgence. Let me just jump right into our hot topics real quick. Also, I will be this next week coming up after Fahrenheit. I will be in Detroit, Michigan for the homegoing celebration of the great late Aretha Franklin. I will be in Detroit on next week for the homegoing celebration, and I will be going live and letting you guys know where we at and letting you know what's going on. Okay, the services, the open public viewing will be Tuesday and Wednesday at the Detroit Museum from 9 to 9, and with the homegoing celebration that Friday the 31st at the Greater Grace Cathedral. Okay, so that's going to be next weekend in Detroit, Michigan, and we will be saluting and saying farewell to the Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin. Okay, and I will be there. I'll be with who? That's history. That's history. I say history. And I'm Otis Mac, and I want to be a part of the history. Excuse my indulgence. Okay, we're going to move forward with our hot topics tonight. We're definitely going to do that. And I might step on some toes, but I want you to know it ain't nothing personal. And I love you to the moon. Michael, I love you to the moon. I love you to the moon, okay? Yeah, we will be in Detroit think I'm going to get in there on Tuesday. Woo! Me and BK, my assistant, and a few other folk are going up to Detroit. Okay. Let's jump right into our hot topics. Tonight, I'm here to Hope You Tonight. Y'all do me a favor. Would you please share the video, Bo? I see you from San Francisco. Y'all share the video. Let them know that we are on live cocktails and conversations sponsored by Equality of Illinois, the proud sponsors of Fahrenheit Chicago, starting here in Chicago this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday right here in Chicago. Y'all meet me at the park, on Sunday, and we have a plethora of t-shirts. We'll be giving out the Heavy Diva t-shirts. Excuse my indulgence. I'm here to hope you cocktails and conversations this Sunday. So if you need a t-shirt, you come on out there. Come on out there. We got t-shirts. We got free giveaways. We got rough and stuff. You know, she a fool. We got Terry DeMore. Terry DeMore, y'all keep her in the prayers. Terry DeMore has lost some weight. Terry DeMore was 486 pounds. She went on the Oprah Winfrey diet, and you will see her on Sunday at the park with us. She went on the Oprah Winfrey diet. She was 486 pounds. Went on that diet, that Oprah diet, baby, and now Terry DeMore is now 482 pounds. Okay, we're here to hope you. Yes, Lord. Listen, what you allow will continue. Now, tonight, I got some hot topics that I'm going to touch on. And like I said, I might step on some toes. Do I look all right? I ain't looking at myself on another screen, but do I look all right? Are y'all catching me? I mean, do you see everything? Did you catch it? You catch it? Mug down. I'm here to listen. Let me know. I need my assistant to tell me if I'm all right, because we got some haters looking at where he at. Is everything okay, Bikayla? Is everything okay? I don't hear none. You say you in Memphis. Oh, thank you, Robert Jones. Okay, all right. All right, Deja Queen, shut up. Listen, hey, Dickie Dior. Listen, we're going camping. There's a lot of stuff going up. But let me tell you, what you allow will continue. A lot of you all are in the sound of my voice. I need you all to grab a mirror. Grab a mirror, and damn it, I want you to look at it. You understand me? Because a lot of you all need to take a look in the mirror and say to yourself, what you allow will continue. And let me share this with you. I said this a few weeks ago. If you're not ready to make changes to your situation, shut the hell up and stop complaining about it. If you're not ready to make the change that you need to change your situation that you allowed yourself to be in, shut the hell up and have what? Several seats. Shut the hell up and have several seats. A lot of y'all complain to me, you complain to people, coworkers, pastors, people, but you complain, but literally you're not really ready to change the situation. A lot of times you allow stuff and allow people to put you in situations that you really don't have to be in. I tell you babies all the time, it's important that you stop allowing people to make their problem your problem. Honey, you can't save the world. And a lot of times y'all, a lot of your folk listening in the sound of my voice think you're the savior. You ain't the savior. You ain't risen. You ain't done nothing like that, baby. So don't try to save everybody. Grown folk need to learn how to be grown folk. Touch somebody on the shoulder and say, grown folk need to learn how to be grown folk. Stop trying to carry everybody's load, every weight. A lot of times we put stress and stuff on ourselves that we don't have to be put, that don't have to be in. We put responsibilities and stress. Our hair falling out. You starting your period early, 6 weeks earlier. You don't have it for 6 weeks and you think you're pregnant, ain't even had no sex. That because you got stress buildup in you, because you got so much stuff that's so much weighing you down. It's weighing you down that it don't have to weigh you down. It ain't even your problem. You sitting here trying to wonder, worry how you trying to take care of your own bills and worry about your own house and household. And then you got somebody else coming up in there making extra bills for you and ain't giving you nothing. Have several seats. You can't save the world. You just can't. And anybody who will allow a grown person to come and lay up in their damn house, free of charge, ain't working, don't want to do nothing, don't have no goals, no future, no plans, you are a damn fool. Reach over and look in the mirror and say, baby, I'm a damn fool. I've been a damn fool for a little while here long, little while here lately. And but now tonight, I want you to tell yourself, baby, I'm tired of being a damn fool. You want to help somebody. You want to be the savior of the world. No, baby, that ain't, no. Help yourself. Let me tell you something. You can have a bunch of thirsty horses. You can lead them to the water, but you damn sure can't make them drink it. And a lot of times we as adults, as friends, as parents, we become enablers for people. Anytime, watch this, anytime you find somebody, I'm going to step on some toes tonight, but I'm here to help you. Anytime you find somebody, I said anytime you find somebody who the family don't want to be bothered with, baby, you better investigate it before you start trying to take on a responsibility that you don't know the whole goddamn story. Excuse my indulgence. Let me tell you something. And then folk can lie so good and lie to you so much, they make you think that the person who they were staying with and where they left from and why they ain't over there no more was just a villain. Was no good. That he or she didn't mean me a bit of good. Baby, he wasn't shit. She wasn't shit. Ain't never done nothing for me. They in it for the money. They ain't bought me nothing. They just they stupid. But you've been up, Otis. I mean, Heavy Diva. I want to get into my personal shit. But let me tell you something. You be mindful of people. You'll be mindful of people. But if your mammy don't want you, if your pappy don't want you, if your family don't want you, you better investigate before you start taking on responsibility of people who you really don't know, who came to you singing a song or sit at your damn table and cried.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do.
And you fall for it, and then they say, well, I got this ass. You know, because you don't know people. You don't know them. You don't know. But guess what? You will know. Anything in the dark gonna eventually come to the light. Sometimes it might take weeks, sometimes it might take months. But if it's like a cancer, it's in remission. But girl, eventually that cancer gonna steam up again and shake you up. Go shake you up. I'm here to help you, baby. Sometimes they can try to suppress it. Oh, good. I'm gonna keep this down. But it's time for us as people to start letting grown folk be grown folk. One thing Otis Mack learned, and I'm a professional, I believe in letting grown folk be grown folks. Scripture says, and this is not a biblical show, Darlene, when I was a child, I spoke as a child and I've done childish things. Now that I became a man / woman, I put away my childish ways. You cannot save the world. You cannot save the world. It's a song that was made some years ago, so it says, sweep around your own front door before you try to sweep around mine. It's something about me. And then this, I'm talking about myself. I don't care. See, I know who I am, and I know whose I am. I know who I am, and I know whose I am. You understand me? So I don't need to be your friend, your good girlfriend, your good girlfriend. I don't need no damn friends. Hell, I got thousands of them all over the world. You understand me? And I'm not distraught, I'm not hurt by anything, and I don't want you to be either. But I need you to take care of your business. Take care of your house. Don't have nobody laying up in your damn house for nothing. And watch this. I got some buddies. Oh, yeah, we roommates. No, we ain't roommates, honey. Because roommates got in this thing together, and roommates paid, split all the bills together. That's what a roommate is. No, we ain't no roommate. You got a room up in my spot for a little while. Excuse my indulgence. Mm-mm. But do you know that people will get comfortable in your spot? People will get comfortable and they will start questioning you and saying that they ain't got the money, they don't want to pay you, don't want to do nothing. And anybody who will let a grown person lay up in their house for free, you are a damn fool. You are a damn fool. Touch somebody and say, you are a damn fool. No, 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 no. I have a rule up in here. See, as for me in my house, I'm 45 years old, the true version of 45. If I can get up and go to all three of my jobs every morning, you can get your ass up and go too. You're going to get up out of here. And you're going to get tired of sitting in the park and on the bench, and that's your good girlfriend's house. See, that's going to get old. That's going to get old. I'll be less than a man, and you should be less than a man or a woman to let some able-bodied person just lay up in your house and not do nothing. Because some of them get a check every month, and they ain't doing a bitch go to the library. You just ain't going to sit up in Mr. Mack's house, I promise you. And you all shouldn't do that either. And don't let nobody come up in your house, laying up in your house, and make you feel uncomfortable. You sitting around in your hat coming out in patches. You smoking cigarettes and you ain't smoked in years. Nobody should come in your house and make you uncomfortable or frustrated. But what you allow will continue. I don't care if it's your aunt, your cousin, your baby daddy, your I don't care who it is. I don't care. But tonight I'm here to help you. Sometimes you just gotta shock the shit out of people. Sometimes you just have to shock the shit out of them. And I'm sorry, but this ain't no biblical show, but I know I got some biblical folk watching and some groups that I'm in who are spiritual. But if you're spiritual, you know, it is what it is. You sometimes got, listen, no, no, no. Some of y'all need to get up in the morning and say, baby, today's your last day. Listen, don't watch this. Watch this. If you got checks coming in, that means you got some income. You got somewhere to go. You understand? Today is your last day. I love you, but I can no longer, I will no longer allow you to sit up here in my house and make me uncomfortable, make me stressed, frustrated, and get me stressed out. It got to end today. Right now, this is it. Call who you need to call, and I love you, and I will see you at the family reunion, and I will speak to you. If you don't speak to me, I'm gonna still speak to you, but it stops right here. I have children. I don't need no other assistance, no other folk just laying around me not doing nothing. I don't produce losers. Otis Mack produced winners. And all anybody who knows me and who knows me, there's never been a time if anybody ever stayed here in my house. My life's been off, my gas been off, my phone been off, I didn't have nothing to eat. I don't roll like that. I'm a blessed child. I'm a king's kid. But no, you're not going to lay up on me. Excuse my doing. That ain't going to happen. And you shouldn't let nobody. I had a woman call me crying. I don't know what to do. I said, baby, let me tell you what to do. Tell him to get the hell out. End of coming. Because watch this. If you let him stay there too long, you can't put him out. Get out, baby. Baby, I can't do it. I try. I can't. Stop letting allowing people to make their problem your problem. What you allow will continue. Don't do that to yourself. Don't beat yourself up. Baby, if you stop talking to me because I'm tired of helping your grown ass girl, okay. Okay. When you come to your senses and get, you will understand. He was just trying to help me. It looked hard. It's cold. You know what I'm saying? And watch this. I'm here to help you tonight. Right now, we are in the summer, headed to the fall. This is a good time to get put out. You ain't got to be out there while it's cold. Don't wait till end of October, November, December, and say you're going to put them out. You're going to put them out in the cold. Now, put them out now. Now. In the morning. Walk by tonight while they sleeping and say, hey, how you doing, baby? Tonight's your last night here. You got to go tomorrow and go on to sleep. We ain't got to have no big conversation about this. You don't owe them anything. And that's where you get caught up. I don't want them to feel bad. I don't want them to think I don't like you. But you don't care nothing, and they don't care nothing about you being stressed out in your own house because you're trying to help them, and you're frustrated about it. No, just walk by. Hey, you doing, baby? And we can sit and watch TV, have a beverage. How you doing? Yeah, baby, what's going on? Done, tonight's your last night here. You got to leave tomorrow. Huh? You got to leave tomorrow. I'm going to go to bed. We ain't got to have no long drawn out conversation. Because watch this. We didn't have no long drawn out conversation when you move your ass in. We didn't write no sign, no contracts or nothing. I need to play game. He ain't these nuts. Baby, tomorrow is your last day. So whoever you've been talking to on the phone all day, cacking and kicking, and while you've been laying up in my house, they ain't washed the dishes, they ain't vacuum, ain't sweep the floor, you ain't done nothing while I was at work. Nothing. But got up and got and cooked you something to eat. You ain't even act like you appreciate being here. Ain't cleaned up nothing. Ain't done nothing. It's time to go. Tomorrow, baby, that's it for you. And I love you. And anywhere you need me to take you, I'll take you. But it stops tomorrow. In the morning, baby, that's it. I'm done. I love you, though. Oh, I love you. And we can go to dinner next week when you get your check. Sometimes you got to shock a person. You got to stick them right there. Tomorrow is your last day. Today is your last day. It's early. It's 8 o'clock. Baby, I'm going to meet you out of here by 4:30, 5 o'clock. Come and find you somewhere to go. You don't have to give them no explanation. And a lot of times we put ourselves in a situation because we try to, I don't know what they're going to say. I don't care what they're going to say. They don't care how you're feeling. And they sit there and do what they do because you don't say anything. But guess what? It stops right here. People will only do to you what you allow them to do. People will only do to you what you allow them to do. Well, I don't want to hurt their feelings. Oh, that's my kinfolk. Oh, that's good. When you put their ass out, guess what? They're going to still be their kinfolk, your kinfolk. Go stay with some other kinfolk. You stayed here long enough. Your time here is over. That's all. Listen, y'all. It ain't no shade. We're not being mean. I wish I could read some of these comments. Go. You know, I wish I could, but I have to go back and read them later. But, you know, see, you don't want to be. You know what I'm saying? I mean, and it's not being mean. But there is no reason why this is your house and you got to be frustrated in your own house when you're helping a grown person out. Now, keep in mind, I said a grown person. I don't see nobody 14, 15 years old who's mischievous. Excuse my indulgence. I said a grown person. A lot of y'all got grown people sleeping on y'all couch, sleeping in the extra best guest bedroom, sleeping downstairs, sleeping on the floor. And they ain't doing nothing. They're in between jobs. Mm-hmm. You are becoming an enabler. You're in between jobs, but you're going to be in between jobs outside my door. Nathan say it might be tight, but it's right. And that is so true. That is so true. Watch this. I'm gonna tell you a story, and I don't want to step on no toes, but it's right, and it's good. I have a family member who was going through some things. Watch this. Going through some things, and they got a husband. I have a full finished garden apartment at the time. And I told my family member, I said, baby, you are more than welcome to come to my home and stay in my garden apartment, which is a full furnished garden apartment with a full bedroom, full white room, front room, and an extra bedroom, and an extra party room. You are more than welcome to come and stay here with me. But your husband can't come. Your husband can't come. Now you can come, but your husband can't come. I know what you mean, Odin, and I'm gonna come over there. I'm gonna come in. This was in February. I'm gonna come in April. April? Girl, let's get April. You ain't doing nothing. Now he ain't doing nothing. April? This February. Why you gotta wait till April? Okay. So come April, the deal was off. No, boo. Sorry, I let my son move down there. Mm-mm. Some folk don't want to let go of mess. There is no reason why you married. You with a nigga, you with a girl, ain't neither one of y'all doing nothing, and what you do goes to him or her, and y'all ain't doing nothing. That's hogwash. That's hogwash. You understand me? And I opened the door because I love her. Come on, stay here with me. I didn't tell her I wanted nothing but to pay the cable bill and the light bill. You know what I'm saying? You can't stay nowhere for free, y'all. You can't stay nowhere for free. I said you can't stay nowhere for free. And how many times have y'all had folks you invited to stay in your in the guest bedroom or something and say, baby, I need $400. $400? Well, you ain't got to pay. Go to the YMCA. You grown. You can't stay nowhere for free. You can't stay nowhere for free. You can't, no, you grown. You got Louis Vuitton purses, Gucci's, Coach, Catch, Michael Kors, they all knock off. Yeah, they all knock off. Sometimes you gotta fake it till you make it. Mm-mm. You can't stay nowhere for free. You want somebody to help you? Go to the Salvation Army, to the shelter, to the Goodwill. That's what they do. That's what they do. That ain't what I do. That ain't what I do. Salvation Army, the shelter, Goodwill, what's their names? Bunch of folks. All of them, you know, Pacific God Mission, all those people. That's what they do. Aunt Martha's. That's what they do. That ain't what I do. That ain't what I do. And don't ever let nobody come up in your house and set a price for what you're going to charge them. Ever. You want to set a price, you need to go get your own place and set a price. Excuse my indulgence. You come up in here, this is what I want. If you can't afford, then you can't come up in. See, one thing Otis Mack believes in, and I'm here to help you tonight, you need to teach folk. When you go rent an apartment, the landlord is going to tell you how much they want for that room, that one-bedroom, two-bedroom, studio, efficiency apartment, Airbnb, or whatever it is. They're going to tell you what the going rate is. They ain't letting you come, oh, stay here till you get caught up. No. So if you're going to stay in my spot, I'm going to tell you what it is. Now, if you don't want it, you don't have to stay in my spot. And I'll still talk to you and we'll still be cool. Because one thing, and I tell you all, baby, and I want you all to run with this before I get up out of here. Y'all share this video. If you get a spot, and if you can't afford it by yourself, don't get it. If you can't afford it by yourself, don't get it. Because, see, folk will let you down. Folk will turn on you. Folk will, yeah, they will. Oh, I let her have it. I walked up out of there. Now she got to move because she can't afford the place. Lies and garbage, girl. Lies and garbage. See, I was making it before you got here. And I'm going to be making it while you gone. But if you can't afford a spot, you better get something you can afford. Let me tell you something. If you can't afford a spot, even if you got a roommate and y'all want to go on this thing together, get a spot whereas if they start showing their ass and start acting up or meet a lover and go on about their business, you won't be stuck in a spot that you can't afford. Baby, if you know all you can afford is $1,200 a month, that's what y'all both better get, $1,200. If you can't afford it by yourself comfortably, say, no, but we can't do this. Because, see, you might leave. You know what they say, shit happens. Excuse my indulgence. Stuff happens. People change. And how many times y'all agree with been in some type of agreement, and they'd have met some boy or some girl?
Well, baby, I'm going to move in with them.
And leave you stuck. No, ma'am, you ain't going to leave me stuck. I'm good, girl. I'm good. All right. See you now, you here. Mm-mm. If you can't afford it by yourself, baby, don't get it. Because people will let you down. What you allow will continue. People will only do to you what you let them do. Stop letting people take advantage of you. Excuse me? If you want to take advantage, you might need to go to Advantage Chevrolet in Bolingbrook and Willowbrook. That's Advantage Chevrolet. You ain't going to take advantage of me. And watch this. Some of your greatest hurts, we moving forward, some of your greatest hurts will come from people who you helped. I'm going to hide behind the veil. Ooh, y'all send me an offering, because I just said something. Some of your greatest hurt will come from people you've helped. I'm here to help you tonight. But something unlike a lot of people, when I help people, when I do things for people, I do it from here. I do it from my heart. See, what I do for people, I don't do for accolades. I don't do for self-gain. I don't do for your, Otis done this. I do it because I love people and I love God. You understand me? Let me say this, and I'm going to step on some toes, but it is what it is. I am a licensed foster parent and have been a licensed foster parent with the state of Illinois for the last 21 years. Not only am I a licensed foster parent, I have worked in social service professionally for the last 17 years. Follow me, if you will. And something about me, and I'm about to tell you this, and I'm gonna take my seat. I have fostered over 28 children, I have fostered over 28 children, and I've done it because I love them. And I've done it because I love people, and I love God. And if I can help somebody as I travel along the way, my living won't be in vain. I never have fostered for financial gain. That's why I work every day. My children will tell you, my children and their children will tell you that daddy have taken us around the world. We have been to Jamaica, Honduras, Cancun, the Cayman Islands, the Bahamas, Hawaii,
a plethora of places. For the last 10 years, I cruise every Christmas with my children. Are you following me? I've done this to so they will remember. If that fat nigga ain't done nothing for me, he took me around the world. He showed me places that I probably would have never seen in my life. But I've done it because I love God. I love God, and I'm a loving person, and I do it because I love children. I love people. I didn't do it for self-gain. No. I've done it. Some of these kids had never been on a plane. They had never lived the way we live. They had never been in a limousine. They had never been on a cruise ship. But I wanted to leave that everlasting impression that if they never remember anything about me, they will tell you that Mr. Mack, although he was stern, and he meant what he said, and he said what he meant. But what he done for us was genuine. It was genuine. I done it because I love him. You understand? I love people. I want to leave that example on these children. I want my tombstone to read, oh, this love people. And he loved God. Oh, he was stern. Oh, he didn't take no shit. But he was genuine. And what I do for people and for my children, I do it because I love them. You understand me? I love them. And I want to leave that impression on them. I want to leave that impression that life can be good. Life can be good and exciting. Life is only what you make it. You understand? You understand? You understand me? You understand me? You understand me? I do. But sometimes I tell you this, some folk are just like they are. And I don't wish them no bad news and no bad luck. You understand me? People hate that about me being stern yet genuine. They say I'm mean. Yeah, they say I'm mean too. Robbie, they do. They say, Mr. Mack is mean. But if you look at the flip side, Mr. Mack is mean, but he's genuine and he loves us. He loves us. They never wanted for anything. And even when I said no, I said yes. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, when you've done all you can do, and you've done it from your heart, you know you're good. Even when those who you have helped will speak and say all manner of evil against you. Do good anyway. After you've done all you can, just stand. Anytime you've had somebody who you've helped for 3, 4, 5 years, and they can walk by you and not speak to you, but you can still smile, out of respect alone, you've never beat them, they've never been hungry, you just were stern and straight, and they gonna walk by you and not speak. It is what it is. I did tell you earlier, it's just like a cancer. They've been hiding it, the phoniness, for all this time, but that cancer then resurfaced. And now Mr. Mack or Mr. Smith or Miss Williams is a bad person. And they will talk about you like you've never done nothing for them. When really, you helped them when they were at their lowest. When they were at their lowest. You reached and grabbed them. But don't feel bad, because if you're like me, you've done it because you have a heart. Because you have a heart. I've had some people who I've raised, and I don't want to mention their names, but you know I will, because what are they going to do to me? who have got on Facebook, and if you didn't know me, you would think, oh, I cannot believe that about this man. I cannot believe he did. Oh, really? If you didn't know me. But I know who I am, and I know whose I am. Mm-hmm. I know who I am, and I know whose I am. And how about this? How many times you have helped people, and they go and drag your name through the mud? But see, something about Mr. Mag, I know my name. And I know my name, and not only do I know my name, my neighbors know my name. Listen, I'm here to help you tonight. I am here to help you. Let me tell you this as my last topic. Minding your own business. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Sometimes people need to mind their own business. Now, evidently, now something when you have been brought up by respectful and God-fearing parents. Respectful and God-fearing parents. I had a mother and I had a daddy. Watch this, I'm gonna go even further. I had a mother and I had two daddies. But they were respectful and God-fearing people. I'm a single guy, 46 years old. I'm the full version of 44. You'll catch that on the way home. I will say this to you. I love God and I love people. If I can help somebody as I travel on the way, Dwayne Patrick, hey, brother, my living won't be in vain. Listen, this has been Cocktails and Conversations, episode number 34, and we are sponsored by Fahrenheit Chicago. Don't forget, this weekend is Fahrenheit Chicago, starting Friday with our skate party at the rink at 1122 East 87th Street from 12 to 3 a.m. And we got a couple of celebrities who's going to come to the building from Love and Hip Hop. Then Saturday, we got a big rooftop party at the Promontory from 3 to 9 p.m. And then Sunday is the grand finale at the Oakwood Beach at 41st and Lakeshore Drive. We'll move right down the street so you guys will have ample parking from 11 to 7:30. With myself, Rough and Stuff, Terry Damore, Teresa Griffin, Tank, and a cast of divas and DJs from all over the country from 11 to 7:30. It is the LGBTQ Pride Experience at Oakwood Beach. And don't forget, next week we will be in Detroit, Michigan for the homegoing celebration of the godmother of the Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin. She will lie in state Tuesday and Wednesday at the Detroit Museum from 9 to 9, and also Friday at the Greater Grace Cathedral for the homegoing celebration. So make sure you send us a prayer and make sure you do what you do. Fahrenheit Chicago is in full effect. Don't forget, I'm here every Wednesday night for Cocktails and Conversations Facebook Live at 10:30. We will have free t-shirts and giveaways at Fahrenheit, so make sure you come on out and make sure you get the t-shirt, honey, okay? Make sure you get the t-shirt. As I leave this night, let me share this with you. Someone wanted me to talk about sex. I want to say something real quick about sex. Somebody say, oh, does the Bible say the bedroom is undefiled? Well, let's make some clarity on that. Excuse my indulgence. When they say the bedroom is undefiled, that means nobody should be able to come into your bedroom but your spouse. That don't mean having threesomes. That means it's undefiled, meaning they shouldn't come up in there. You understand me? But let me share this with you. A lot of times what you won't do for your mate sexually, somebody else will. You can't tell me I love you till death do us part, and I need you to do it, lick a little something in this area, and in this area, and you don't want to do it because that's what I feel, then that's what you need to do. And if you don't do it, there's some wonderful person around the corner on the second floor by the alley who would do it. I had one kid who used to tell me, Mr. Mac, $20 is $20. Listen, let me share this with you. I will also be, let me tell you what I'm going to be, and I'm going to tell you God is good. Reach over and tell somebody that God is good. This weekend, all weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, I'm working for Fahrenheit Chicago, who is my sponsor for my show tonight. Thank you so much, Abby Galloway and Equality of Illinois. Thank you so much. Friday night, we'll be at the rink. Saturday, we'll be at the promontory. And Sunday, we will be at Oakwood Beach. And also, don't forget my partner, Ruffin Stuff, Terry DeMore, and myself. We're going to all be together on that main stage for Fahrenheit with Teresha Griffin and Tank that Sunday at Oakwood Beach from 11 to 7 p.m. Excuse my indulgence. And I'm going to say this to you, and I'm going to take my seat. May the works I've done speak for me. May the life I've lived speak for me. May the service I've gave speak for me. On next Saturday, I will be featured. I will be at the Vic Theater. And get your tickets at the Vic Theater. I'll be at the Vic Theater on Sheffield. I'll be hosting Mr. Continental at the Vic Theater. Y'all might as well make some noise. May the works I've done speak for me. I want to send a big kudos out to Jim Flint and the staff of the Baton and the Continental Patronage System. Thank you for allowing me to be your host for your Mr. Continental. Thank you so much. I will be there in full gear on next Saturday at the Vic Theater. Continental, Mr. and Continental will convene next Friday. The prenum night will be at the Baton. Next Saturday will be at the Vic Theater. Next Friday will be at the Baton Show Lounge. Next Saturday will be at the Park West. I'll be hosting Mr. Continental final night at the Park West Theater. Do excuse me. Then next Sunday, will be at the Vic Theater for Miss Continental, and next Monday, Labor Day Monday, will be the final night of Miss Continental at the Vic Theater. And I'm honored to be a part of that aggregation. I will be the thing. BK, man, I want to tell you something. I want to tell you publicly, I love you, man. I love you for being a part of my team. I love you being a part of my life. And I love you because I love you, okay? And thank you so much. But so you all join us. We'll be at the Vic and at the Park West on Armitage and Clark on Saturday. I'll be the special guest MC for Mr. Continental. Okay? Yes. Oh, my God. The one time. You can come on, Andre. Come on, Andrew. I'm going to be there. So make sure. I think they have a few general admission tickets left for Mr. Continental. I believe I did. Reads that there's general admission tickets left for Mr. and Mrs. Continental. All the reserve seats I do know are sold out, but that's Friday will be at the Baton, Saturday will be at the Park West for Mr. Final Night, and then Sunday will be at the Vic, and Monday the final night will be at the Vic. So I believe tickets are whatever they are, you just buy them, okay? But I love you, and ain't nothing you can do about it. Excuse my indulgence. Something else is coming up. I'm going to be, oh, don't forget, I'll be at the funeral at the homegoing celebration at for Aretha Franklin. Dickie Dior, man, I want to tell you, I love you. I love you, and you hold on in there. We're going camping, and I'll be in New York City September the 28th through October 2nd, I believe, 28th, October 1st. I'll be in New York. So if you're in New York, look me up. I'll tell you more about that as we get. I'll be in New York. I know September 28th, I'll be in New York. I'll be in Gettysburg, Tennessee on October 19th. Okay. But listen, I love you and ain't nothing you can do about it. This has been our 34th episode of Cocktails and Conversations right here, Facebook Live. Facebook Live. Facebook Live. I said Facebook Live. Cocktails and Conversations. Don't forget to join me tomorrow morning for my spiritual vitamin. Baby, I had a song I wanted to play, and Facebook, no, I don't own the rights to this music. But in commemoration of Aretha Franklin and everything that's going on around the country, I wanted to leave this with you tonight. I wanted to leave this with you. Y'all tell me where you from. Ferris Miles, I'm out. Ferris, man, I want to tell you something. I love you so much. It is good to have good friends. Ferris, Kalasia, Eric, Antoine, Kalanda. I love you guys. Pepper LaBasia. Listen. Facebook, I do not own the rights to this music. But in the remember of Aretha Franklin, the Queen of Soul. And everything that's going on in our society tonight, everything that's going on around the country, I need y'all to hear this. Fahrenheit Chicago is in full effect. And the sin and the darkness. This is the Love Center Choir. I want y'all to hear this tonight. Markham, Illinois, I see you. A&W Cleaning Services, hit me up, baby. I'll send you all the information. I will be at the Park West Saturday, Labor Day Saturday. Tomorrow, Friday, I'll be at the rink, 87th Street. I'll be at the Promontory in Hyde Park on Saturday, and I'll be at Oakwood Beach on Sunday. If you go to my page, everything is there. Fahrenheit Chicago, sponsored by Equality of Illinois. Would y'all share this video? It's time for me to go. I got 3 more minutes. I'm up out of here. Thank you, Cordero. Is T-Talk coming back, Cordero? That's good, baby. Listen. Danville, I see you. Listen. Then the Lord said. Y'all listen to this song. Listen. New Jersey, I see you. I need a stroke. Stokes, y'all do me a favor. Share this video. Raise your feet. Excuse my indulgence. For there is nothing too hard. All the crime and stuff that's going on around the country, I want you to know there's nothing too hard. Listen. Terry DeMar, Rough and Stuff, and myself will be hosting Fahrenheit Chicago. Listen, this weekend, at Oakwood Beach. It's a time. Ooh. To show. Facebook, I do not own the rights to this music. And this is not a biblical show, but I just think y'all need to hear this tonight. 60 shootings in Chicago the weekend. Episode number 34, Cocktails and Conversation. I'm Otis Mack, Chicago's Heavy Diva.
Don't let go, y'all. And I need y'all to hold on for life. Listen, hold on. And while you're holding on, I need you to plant your feet on a solid foundation. In the midst, place your what? Listen what you say. Flame Monroe, I see you, girl. How are you, baby? Thank you, baby. Thank you, Mary. He is the one who will deliver all the killing, all the fighting, all the hate that that's going on in the world and even our community. Excuse my nose. This has been the 34th episode of Scott Sylvan Conversation. I'm on my way up out of here. Thank you, Mary. I love you too, Andrew. Debbie, I love you, baby. Ooh, you're not. Ooh. Grab it. Y'all need to hit it. Ooh. Excuse my indulgence. Place your feet, baby. We got people who say they're leaving Chicago because of the crime. But don't leave without your children, because if your children who doing all the killing, take their little asses with you. Woo! He's the one! If this ain't no biblical show, well, I love God and I love people. I gotta go. I gotta go. I gotta go. Terry DeMore says she feel like praying and can't see. This has been my 34th episode of Cocktails and Conversation. Listen, I'm Otis Mack, Chicago's heavy diva. I gotta go. Listen, I love you. I love you. God bless you. Thank you. Don't forget, this weekend is Fahrenheit Chicago at Oakwood Beach. That's Sunday. The last day is Sunday. We start on Friday. And Friday at the skating rink at 1122 East 87th Street at the rink. Saturday at the promontory. And then Sunday, last night at Oakwood Beach. I gotta go, y'all. I know y'all want me to keep it.
Hallelujah.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Michael Cox. Darlene, I gotta go. Facebook, I don't own the rights to this music.
For every time that you protected me when I didn't know your name. Hey. How you loved on me and cared for me when I didn't return the same.
This ain't no biblical show, but you know I love.
Now when it seemed like I was losing and I felt like giving up, I gotta say.
Okay. This has been our third. I appreciate it, Joe. Okay, listen, this has been. Listen, I appreciate you tonight. Thank you for tuning in for Cocktails and Conversations. Facebook, I don't own the rights to this music. But if I can help somebody, as I travel along the way, my living won't be in vain. Okay. Thank you. I'm out of here. Thank you, Anthony Galloway, man. Thank you, Equality of Illinois. Thank you, Jim Flint. Thank you, Ruffy. John Baker, BK. My staff, thank you, baby. My family, thank you. I'm good. I just had a moment. I'm sorry. I want to say, excuse my indulgence. Would y'all do me a favor and share this video? Because somebody needs to hear this tonight. I'm okay. I'm just a big baby. I love people. And I love God. I'm just solid. And I don't mind. All that I have is because of him. I want my cocktail and conversation to have something in the show to be genuine. I don't care nothing about no numbers. Ooh, I'm okay though. I just had a moment. I'm sorry. I ain't sorry, I'm good. Facebook, I need to type that in here that I do not own the rights to this music. I'm going to type that up there so I won't have no problem. I'm good, BK, I'm good. You know, I just love God, man. If folks would say stuff about you like you are just a mean old man, but I know who I am, and I know whose I am.
To the Lord, thank you. Yes, me. So many reasons.
reasons. And let me apologize for starting Pillow Talk and didn't can finish. Because Facebook sent me a message and said I can't do that.
Well, I don't know what I do. So I came to New Birth today to tell the Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Listen, this has been our 31st episode of Cocktails and Conversation. I'm Otis Max, Chicago's Heavy Diva. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for tuning in. And don't forget Fahrenheit this weekend here in Chicago, sponsored by Equality of Illinois. Okay? Thank you. I love you. I gotta go, y'all. I gotta go. I gotta go. Michael Henderson, I love you. Darlene, thank you, baby. I want to go, but I just can't. Facebook, I don't own the rights to this music. I got to go. I'm going to be here by myself. If you want us keeping with the music, just call my phone. Because that's what we need to ask them. Change us. Thank you, Deborah. I love you all.
Wash me through and through.
Created me. I'm gonna go. I gotta stop. Excuse my dumbness. Fahrenheit, Chicago. This week, I'm gone. 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 I need y'all to hear this. Listen, listen. Y'all hear this? Is this my last song? And this ain't even no biblical show. Watch this. Listen, listen. And I had a topic tonight. I'll talk about it in the morning. Listen, sometimes we need to hide. Hide me. Cover me from the enemy. Oh, hide. Hide me. One more chance. I'm sorry, y'all. When my strength is weak. What, BK? I'm gonna go. You know what, baby?
Lord, I'm asking you.
I gotta go, y'all. Y'all need to hear that. I'm gone. This is Otis Mack with Cocktails and Conversation, episode number 34. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight, and I'm going to leave this with you tonight, and we're going home, okay? We are going home. Don't forget that Fahrenheit Chicago, Equality of Illinois, I love you. Thank you, Chicago. I just need you. And this ain't no biblical show. But I need y'all to hear this because so many of you all are in a situation and you need to hear this. I'm gone. I'm gone. I'm gone. I'm gone. Listen, listen. Crystal Rucker.
If you're thirsty, thirsty for God and his presence, what you need, you already have.
What you need, all you already have. Oh, powerful.
Supernatural is released when you give him your all.
Listen what she say. Thank you, Crystal.
When I come
end of myself, there I will end in. Hey, to the end
of myself, that's when I.
BK, I'm gone. Thank you, Crystal.
If you're thirsty, thirsty for God and his presence, what you need, you already have. The all-powerful, supernatural is released when you give him your all.
Listen.
When I come to the end of myself, that's when I
I gotta go.
When I get there, at the end of the
don't forget Fahrenheit Chicago this weekend.
When I release all of my problems, all of my burdens, when I come to the end, that's when I can enter in. Oh, when I come to the end, after all the things that I've been through, all the things that didn't go my way, when I get to the end of being hurt and abused, when I get to the end of being misunderstood and used, when I come to the end of what the doctor said, when I come to the end, oh, when I get there,
excuse my indulgence. This has been Cocktails and Conversation. Yeah.
Thank you all so much for tuning in to Cocktails and Conversations. This has been episode number 34. I'm going to leave you tonight. I'm going to leave you with this, and I'm gone. Good night, Chicago. I want you to know this ain't no biblical show, but I love God and I love people. Thank you for tuning in.
Everybody's talking about you and her together. What could you do to me? And everybody's talking about all the wonderful things you do with her. You still with me. Can't tell by the look on my face. I thought I knew it right. Now I can hardly remember why.
Hey, Victor. Thank you, LaDia D. Conversations over, darling. This is it. Good night, Chicago. Good night. Terry, that's what I want you to do, baby. Y'all send me some hearts. I'm on my way up out of here. Everybody, this is my last number. Hey, Earl, to Diva, y'all share the video. Would y'all do that? If you ain't ready for me to go, let me know. I'll say what they gonna do to me. Thank you for sharing the video. I care for you too. Oh, wow. Don't forget Fahrenheit Chicago, Equality of Illinois, this weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Excuse my indulgence. We're out of here. Oh, I love the heart. Thank you, baby. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Batavia, I gotta go. Facebook, I'm gonna type it in. I don't own the rights to this music. Listen, I'm Otis Mac Chicago with Heavy D, but this has been episode number 34 of Cocktails and Conversations. I love people. I love God. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight. Y'all get to go get you some sleep. Get you some sleep now. Get you some sleep. Get you some sleep. Okay? I gotta go. God bless you and good night. And I'm gonna leave.
Like
I wanna say, listen, listen.
Church, why you can stand right there? Yeah.
I'm gone. I wanna tell you I love you.
Church, why, but if you know it, come on, sing it with us.
You know our DJs, baby. I just love people. And I thank you all for tuning in tonight. I'm finna go, y'all. Facebook, you know I own the rights to this music. And I'm finna go for y'all start talking some stuff. And I don't want no problem out of y'all. Because all my life, I had to fight. You understand me? All my life. God bless you. Good night. Good night. I'm going to leave this one song with you and I'm gone. I promise you. Whatever you're going through tonight, this is for you. Fair High Chicago. Teresa Griffin and Tank. I know BK, I'm gonna go. Whatever you need, just ask. Listen, if I can stay at 50, I'll stay on, I don't care. Y'all share the video. Thank you, Sapphire. I'm out of here. Good night, Chicago. I'm going to do my best to carry you through this week. Good night. This has been Cocktails and Conversations, episode number 34. I'm out. They won't even let me close. Good night, Chicago. God bless you. See you next week. The Oxford Sea tomorrow morning for Cox 4, my spiritual vitamin.